going to the, now we're going to the manufacturing drawback, right? All right, so a manufacturing drawback, just like change condition on used merchandise, is also using the lesser off rule. So a lesser off rule of 99% rule is applicable to direct identification manufacturing drawback. So just like with this example over here, change unused merchandise condition, change unused merchandise change condition, you look at the lesser amount you pay to Canada, Mexico, and you just take 99% of that. What is the proper amount of drawback per unit due to U.S. producer who imports materials from Japan, pays $2 per unit in duty, deposits $1 in anti-dumping duties, and then uses material as a component in the manufacture of a NAFTA-originating product he exports to Canada? So Canada is duty-free. So we have a manufacturing drawback, which is 99% rule, right? So what do we have here? Remember, anti-dumping duties are not refundable, right? Where did we see that? Anti-dumping duties. So no drawback for anti-dumping duties. I abbreviate it as ADD, right? No drawback for anti-dumping. It's just a rule. Countervailing duties, anti-dumping duties, agricultural fees, substitution type, no refund, right? And then we have another potential one, $2 per unit in duty. So you have $2 per unit in duty, right? But then, so to the United States, but $0, right, to Canada. So lesser off rule applies to Canada, which is $0. So 99%. So 99% of zero is zero. So obviously, the poor guy who is engaged in the manufacturing doesn't get any break. So he doesn't get any duty refund. No duty refund for anti-dumping, and no duty refund because of lesser off rule. Because no duty paid to Canada. And that's obviously less, zero duties is less than $2 in duties per unit. So here, A is the correct answer choice. MPF, there is for merchandise processing fee, you can get the refund. There is complications with that. It's more complicated than just but there is no ban on MPF drawback, but there is certain calculations you have to do. More specifically, we should be talking about this in a regular non-NAFTA duty drawback discussion, which is a totally separate provision. So A here is the correct answer, zero.